Hi, this is James at Bespoke. Welcome back to the vlog. Now, many of you have been asking questions about our custom spray jobs, and I'm very, very sorry that I've been a bit hit and miss with the information on YouTube, but we're going to get into it today and sort of pick up a little bit more info on what we do here. So, like I said before, we do the stencils, which will be available on the web very soon. We've actually got another G-Spec here. You may have seen one in the previous video. Which we've already base coated in like a desert tan khaki colour. So what we're going to do is we use this base, we use like a light tan base, we'll apply the stencils and then we'll come back and show you when the stencils are all attached and then how we're going to do the airbrushing, so stay tuned. So you can see we've got the VSR in various pieces. When you receive your stencils, you'll actually find they're in one whole page. But what I find easier is to cut them up into more manageable size segments here for when you're peeling them off and applying them. So it's really, really easy. I'm going to go through it just quickly on how you do that. So the biggest part of the Cryptek pattern on the stencil is quite big. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply that to the stock area. You're going to want gaps in between your Cryptek pattern here and there. But what we'll do is we'll get this and all we do is we peel it off like that. Sorry if it's a bit too white here, I'm trying to get lighting. And all you'll see is if they don't quite stick to the clear side, just press down on the clear side and pull it off. You're going to want this all off in one piece, otherwise you're going to have to go back and line everything up, which you don't want to be doing. Be very careful with it. Some of the stencils come on just a white page like this, which you have to pick them off individually, but the Cryptek and the Hex Camo that we've got at the moment comes on a clear sheet like this, which is needed because it's far easier then to space out the design, whereas if you're doing it individually it's going to be quite a bit of a ball ache to get this on and off where you want it. So you want to try and be as random as you can with this. It's going to be hard to do it on camera. Well, let's see how we do this here. Let's go about there. So you're going to apply to the widest part of the body and then we're going to wrap it around the stock like so. Now what you're going to find, like with the VSR, you've got contours here which applying the sheet as a flat base, you're not going to be able to get it round there. So what we're going to do is we're going to apply it as best we can, and then as we've got certain parts of the stencils on, like here, as we peel it off, we're actually it's actually going to come clear of the stencil, and then we can better contour the rest of the rifle here. So just going to quickly try and do that. Might speed this up for you if it's easier. But you'll see, peeling off the pattern here and the stencil stays on the rifle. You might just have to apply a little bit of pressure just to stick the stencil back down. You're going to make sure the stencil's made contact with the rifle. And you can always come back and just snip bits with a sharp blade. If you need to, or you can trim it and use it in like much more areas if you want to as well. So what I'm going to do, just grab my blade and we'll come back when I've got this fully dialed down. As you can see, wrapping it around the rifle here, I've just cut here just so it's easier to wrap this piece round because it can be quite difficult. I say quite difficult, it can just be a little bit tricky. So these stencils aren't set in place where you've got them beforehand too. Obviously you don't want to be moving them around once you've applied another colour. then what that enables me to do, pull it all the way down like this, and then we can start better contouring the rest of the rifle. There we are. So now this is on, what we can actually start doing, as you can see, there's quite a few difficult contours and curves here with the VSR, where you can see the stencils are struggling to get into those gaps, so we're just going to pick those up manually and just put them in and rearrange them as we want them. See, so just a tiny little bit of fettling, got the wrap right round. You can customise this to however you want as well, just by trimming the little certain segments of the stencil. Got it as best as I can through there. Like I say, the VSR has a very difficult contour around the handle, and then what we're going to do, we've got that one on there, we're just going to carry on placing the other stencils where we want them. Bear in mind we need to keep one separate for the scope, and we need to also keep one separate for the suppressor as well. So we'll just put another two, we'll wrap them around the rifle, and then we'll come back when it's done and we'll show you. You can see the one we placed here is placed around the rifle. It's a nice easy curve and a nice easy contour, so it just goes all the way around, and then what we'll do is we'll cut it there where the line of the rifle is, and then just pass it onto the receiver and the barrel as well. And we're back here, as you can see, the Kryptek pattern even, all over the rifle, all up the barrel. See there, so that's ready to be to have the next coat of paint. I'm just going to run you through doing the suppressor. And if you're doing a very thin rifle like the VSR, you'd think it to be the easiest one, but because it's quite a thin, narrow rifle, you may want to just cut these stencils down a little bit to make them a little bit smaller. But you do have that capability if you've got big stocks like on M16s, or if you're doing like something like an AA12 for instance, it'll be great. But if you're doing something like a little bit smaller, then you're gonna want them a little spread out a little bit more. So just cut them down. You can then shape them to whichever way you want. Just put these around here. As you can see there, because the suppressor is so small, we overlap a bit. So what I'll do is I'm just going to try and cut the stencil. Try and make the cut as random as possible. Press that on there, make sure it's stuck down, find a corner, and then we're just gonna peel it back. That's the great thing about these stencils, I've had a bit of thought put into them, because it's a little bit harder with the digi patterns and such that we do as well, but the Kryptek pattern, which would you would struggle putting the frame on and then putting the individual bits and pieces, is going to take you a very long time, and as you can see, that was done there in a matter of like a minute or two. So that's done, that's ready for paint. Pop that up there, and we've just got a bit of stencil left there. The scope's going to be a little bit harder to do, so I'm probably going to do that off camera. It's going to take a little bit of time cutting them, and just what I might do is cut them into smaller sections, or might not go too much with it and just put a little bit here and a little bit there. So I'm going to pop the scope to one side for now, because the base coat's still drying on that one. Take our stencils out of the way as well. Get all the rubbish. And clear it away. So, you want to choose your colours carefully. There's no right or wrong colour. I tend to just try a few and see what I want, obviously. If you're sending your rifle into us to be done, make sure you specify a certain colour that you want. So we've actually got quite a nice green there. So what I'll do is shake that up. get that popped into the airbrush. And as far as, I mean, I'm not as experienced with some out there on YouTube and bits and pieces, but what, from what I can gather, the best thing to do is do really random patterns of the green. So what you want to do, now you don't need to use an airbrush for this, you can use a rattle can. Whether you've got Krylon or you want to nip down to Halfords and get some camouflage paint, it will all work the same. It's exactly the same process, just a different method of putting the paint on. So I've got the stencil here, I'm just going to do slight gradual bits of, try to do this very, very slightly. And all I'm doing is just basically shading the pattern in. Do it nice and random so it's a bit everywhere. I'm going to pop that. A bit of green on the end there. So if you're doing your suppressors and bits and pieces, and you've got like foam in there, I recommend taking it out, depending on what paint you're using. There's some spray paints out there certainly are a little bit more toxic than others, and when applied to like plastics and foams and stuff, they can actually melt, so make sure you've got that out there. Sorry if that's a bit noisy, it's just the compressor kicking in. So we're going to do exactly the same on the rifle. We're just going to apply random areas of green here and there. I think this colour's actually called Dark Earth, but it's not like a flat Dark Earth, it's actually a greenish colour. And like, this isn't like the only way to paint cryptic patterns, this is just one of many, many different methods. What I say is, it don't take my 100% word as, you know, don't take my word as gospel, as they say, but go out there and certainly see what you can find. A great guy to have a look at is a guy in the States. His YouTube channel is called Mon Tactical. He's got some great guides on there showing you different kind of patterns. This is actually his method that we're using here, because I like how he does it. And we're going to leave it there, so I'm just going to pop that up there and lean it on a part that I know is dry with a flat colour, and we'll come back when we've switched the colour out and we'll show you what to do next. So with this type of quick tip that we're doing, like I say, it's completely off the cuff, just to show you how it's done. I'm actually going to apply three colours here and just, like I say, space them out throughout, take the stencils off, and then what you're going to do afterwards is you're going to shade it in. Just going to clean out the airbrush here, bear with me. Take our next colour, which is I think we've just done that one, haven't we? Dark Earth. Yes, yeah, so we've just done the green, so what we're going to do is move on to the next colour, which is quite a similar colour, but I'm just going for really subtle tones here. Move back onto the suppressor. Although I base this in tan, I don't actually want much of the tan colour left because it's quite bright. So, pop that back there. And we'll move back onto the stock. And just the same as before, you'll switch to your next colour using rattle cans. You can use 2, 3, 4 colours, whatever you want to do, however you want to shade it. Actually going to move on to like a olive drab colour next. Carry on, keep shading. You'll notice I haven't based my the rail section on the VSR there, because it's actually the part that gets the most beating, so it's been left as the colour it is. Scopes being taken on and off and such, so just going to top the paint back up. So you're basically building up these lovely shades, and then when you take the stencils off, it's going to leave this lovely shaded effect with the tan areas that are going to be quite prominent where the stencils are, and then you're going to go back over and just shade them in here and there. Yeah, if you want to get your rifle to us for a custom camo spray job, of course, more than welcome. What we will say with the when doing camo spray jobs is you need to leave the rifle with us for a certain period of time. Due to the certain videos that I did beforehand, we have received a few rifles in. You'll have seen actually my own VSR getting the treatment, and then we've had a second VSR and G-spec in for the treatment as well. What you're going to do here is grab the comb, it's disappeared. Where's that gone? I'm going mad. Must have brought it over already. It's hiding behind the primer. So like I say, if you are using an airbrush for this, don't be scared to not clean your airbrush out in between different paints. As long as you're using the same type of paints and they work well in airbrushes, I'm actually just going to put this next colour straight in and it will actually work with the paint that's left on the outside of the cup, just to blend it a little bit better. So we're going to pop our next colour in. Actually going to put more of this paint in because this is going to be our final colour. And doing this spray job compared to the hex cam is so much easier, because what you have to do with the hex cam is you spray within the base colour, you lay your stencils on, spray it again, lay your stencils on, spray it again, lay more stencils on, and then you do a final colour to bring it all in before shading, which is why that rifle's taking so long. And you've got to give it like ample drying time as well. So we're just going to go in with the olive drab. But in the future, we are looking at different paint finishes. We've looked at both Cerakote and Duracote. So we'll be doing some, hopefully doing some proper firearm coatings as well for those that want it. And when you start doing with these stencils, it's going to look like when the first colour went on, it looks a little bit like you've perhaps either picked the wrong colours, done the stencils wrong or such. Just stick with it, because until you get all the colours on, you won't get the full effect of the shading, some different colours, the stencils as well. And again, when we take the stencils off and it reveals that bright tan colour, it's going to look a little bit off too. Because it's going to be so bright tan compared to all the shading that we've done. But then what we do is you pick up the airbrush or you pick up your rattle can, and then we go and shade those areas and blend them in with the Cryptek. So as you can see, this is starting to look like a sniper rifle now. It's starting to look like a proper paint job. I mean, as always, I'm not as naive to think that everything I'm saying is, you know, absolute law. If you've got any pointers, if you see anything that I'm doing that you think there's either an easier way or a better way of doing it, please let me know, and I'll always say it on camera. You know, I'm not one of these people that my word is law. I love hearing off the community, because not only does it get people involved with us here at Bespoke, I've actually learned a lot of things in my time in Airsoft from either customers, friends, people that you meet out on the field. I was always had a bit of a tunnel vision with paint jobs. I never really got too much into it. I did a few basic ones, but that was about it. And it wasn't actually until talking to people that I discovered the world of airbrushing. And like I say, we've invested a lot in the bits and pieces that we need to be able to do this. Just go over, make sure you haven't missed any areas. What we're going do is we're just going to give it a quick blast in the last colour on the rail here, just to get rid of a bit of the black. I've always found with these Tokio Marui rails that even the standard paint comes off pretty much straight away, so don't stress about it too much. Right, now I'm happy with that. It's turned out really well. So we're going to leave that there in this little painting area. Going to clear out our brush. There's only a tiny bit of paint left. Great thing about airbrushing is a little paint goes a hell of a long way. Let's camo the spray booth. Might as well do that while we're here as well. There we go. And then we're just going to put a bit of cleaner in there. Sweat around. Get that out. So now it's probably not the best camera angle for you if you're on YouTube, but I'm trying to do it as quick as I can because there's lots and lots to do here. Let's get this light out of the way. Light that doesn't want to turn off. Spooky. So yeah, welcome back. So you don't need massive amounts of expensive equipment. So I made a makeshift booth here in the workshop. Just add some old racking, some cardboard to make sure the paint doesn't start flying everywhere. And I'll try and grab this in some more normal lighting for you. But you can see the shading. Let's step. Where's best to stand? You can see the shading on that, and then you can see the pattern, so it's starting to look like Cryptex. So again, with the stencils, you'll probably see, notice on the stock, it's got like a sharp line there. It's not a problem, because as soon as we get the stencils off and we come to shading, we can hide all that if you want to. So what we're going to do, we're going to leave this overnight to make sure it's fully cured. I'm going to come back tomorrow, spray some, take the stencils off, spray some more colours, spray some matte varnish, and then get to it. So thanks for tuning in as always, guys. I tried to make this as exciting, as educational as possible. But with how busy Bespoke is at the moment, with all your orders that are coming in, and all the other bits and pieces, the gun repairs, and all that as well, it's difficult to stay on top of. So I'm going to go home now and spend some time with the missus and have some dinner. So it's James at Bespoke signing off, and we'll see you in the next video, which will hopefully be tomorrow. And yeah, thanks for tuning in, thanks for your support. Give us a like and a subscribe, it helps us immensely, keeps me going, because it knows that you guys want to see more of this. And if there's any questions or any information you need, put it in the comments below. I read all of them and I try and reply to them as much as possible as I can. So do that, guys, and we'll see you tomorrow for the conclusion of the camo spray job. Thanks again.